الحمد لله رب العالمين ولي الصالحين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. الصلاة والسلام على إمام المتقين وقدوة الناس أجمعين وحجة الله على المعاندين سيدنا وحبيبنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. اللهم صل وسلم وزد وبارك على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه آمين. إمام جزاه الله خيرا recited with nice voice the last ayah of Surah Al-Ma'idah. Last ayah of Surah Al-Ma'idah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this ayah, لِلَّهِ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ لِلَّهِ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَمَا فِيهِنَّ وَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. This ayah, if you understand well the deep meaning of this ayah, this is enough for you in the dunya and the hereafter. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explained to us that all things belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The real owner, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The real king, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The king of all kings. Therefore, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prohibit and forbid somebody to name Shahinshah. Shahinshah meaning the king of kings. This only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Malik al-Muluk. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in the first word and letter of ayah, Lillah. Lillah. Lam. Lam. What can be translated as for Allah, to Allah, belong to Allah. But in Arabic have three meaning. In Arabic have three meaning. Lillah. First, the real owner of all whatever in the heaven and the earth. Al-Mulk. Second, Al-Khalq. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala owner. This first. Second, he by himself, subhanahu wa ta'ala, created everything. Can you own something, but ask somebody to take care about this or to make this for you. But Allah by himself, the real owner. Second, he only the creator of all whatever in the heavens and the earth. And third, التدبير. تدبير meaning manage. سبحان الله. The real manager of all things in the heaven and the earth, Allah. So here the meaning of لله, three meaning. First, الملك. Second, الخلق. Third, التدبير. Owner, سبحانه وتعالى. Creator, سبحانه وتعالى. And the manager, سبحانه وتعالى. لله. ملك السماوات والأرض. Anything, seven skies, seven heavens, belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, including whatever, wherever inside these heavens. Also in between heavens and the earth, and also earth and all things inside the earth. All those belong to Allah. So when you think about this, المال مال الله, the money belong to Allah. The soul belong to Allah. All material belong to Allah. You have anything. Allah give you all things. وَاللَّهُ أَخْرَجَكُمْ مِنْ بُطُونِ أُمَّهَاتِكُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ شَيْئًا وَجَعَلَ لَكُمُ السَّمْعَ وَالْأَبْصَارَ وَالْأَفْئِدَةَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you as a baby, subhanallah, without anything. Allah give you a, give you eye, give you heart, give you your heart to gain knowledge, to seek knowledge. لله ملك السماوات والأرض وما فيهن. Then, what is our rule here? والله على كل شيء قدير. Think about this. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all things belong to Allah, why your heart attached with other people? Attached with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Think about the promise of Allah, not think about the promise of people. think about the Allah سبحانه وتعالى الحي القيوم سبحانه وتعالى. الله الحي القيوم جل وعلا وهو على كل شيء قدير. Here we'd like to understand this meaning. وهو على كل شيء قدير. For you to have a good thinking of Allah سبحانه وتعالى حسن الظن. A good thinking that Allah able to do everything by two letters. كن. إنما أمره إذا أراد شيئا أن يقول له كن فيقول. And some scholar explains this ayah. Allah سبحانه وتعالى doesn't need to say كن. Doesn't need to say كن. But this example for us. Without كن, Allah سبحانه وتعالى, if he desires something, if he loves something, will be direct. Subhanallah. So your heart attached with Allah سبحانه وتعالى and Allah only. For example, your money, this is really not your money. This money of Allah and Allah make as a successor, successor خلفاء, مستخلفين فيه. To use this money in the sake of Allah. والله على كل شيء قدير. Meaning, good thinking of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Give example of this. If you face some hardship and ask somebody to help you by advice, by support, of course he will be sympathy with you. He will be good with you. He will make meals for you. But he cannot, or he unable to help you. He only listen to you. Okay, oh brother, جزاك الله خيرا, may Allah support you, I will make dua for you. I cannot to help you. Subhanallah. When you think about Wallahu ala kulli shay'in qadir, that Allah makes you and be able to achieve whatever you want. This point here, husnu al-zann fi Allah. Not husnu al-zann that Allah makes you. This, of course, this first meaning. Second meaning, and they cover your hardship, solve your problem. But come back to Allah, make sujood to Allah, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the nearest place and the position who will be closer to Allah in the state of sujood. أَقْرَبُ مَا يَكُونُ الْعَبْدُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ وَهُوَ سَاجِدْ فَأَكْثِرُوا مِنَ الدُّعَاءِ. Make dua in sujood. You'll be very, very closer to Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from all of you. Allahumma amin ya rabbal alameen. Lillahi mulku samawati wal ardu wa ma fihin. Wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.